Welcome back, everyone, to episode 7 of the 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, where Jennifer Colosimo and I are sharing with you some of the principles from the 7 Habits that can really be helpful and empowering is the word I keep using during this time of challenge and where we feel, you know, powerless. Today on Habit 5, seek first to understand, then to be understood. Just a quick review, we've gone over the 3 habits that surround what we call the private victory. Habit 1 is to be proactive, the habit of choice. Habit 2 is to begin with the end in mind, the habit of vision. And then habit 3 is to put first things first, the habit of execution, putting our plan into action. In the last episode, Jen talked about habit 4, thinking win-win, where it's the habit of an attitude where we have this abundance or can choose to have this abundant mentality versus this scarcity mentality. So of the 3 habits that surround what is called the public victory, habit 4 that Jen reviewed is the first, that's the attitude. And now we're in habit 5, seek first to understand, then to be understood, which is the skill. Now, some people hear that word skill and they think, okay, I'm trying to understand someone and I want to incorporate a skill that feels kind of fake or mechanical. Couldn't be further from the truth if your intent is to really understand people. Habit number 5 is the habit of empathy. And just from the heart, I don't think there is anything more important in the world right now than empathy. I think it's foundational to everything we're trying to do, or it should be. We need to have empathy. Empathy is not sympathy. Empathy is truly hearing and understanding to the best of your ability what the other person is feeling, your boss, your colleague, your spouse or partner, your child, your mother. What are they feeling right now? There's a phrase I use a lot in my work called meet people where they're at. It's my phrase, but I like to remind myself and others of that with every interaction, we're all in different places. And I may be a father and my best friend may be a father, but we have different relationships with our kids. You know, a phrase that I learned a long time ago from Ann Landers. Most of you don't even know who Ann Landers is, but she was a columnist when I was a little kid. And I don't know why I was reading Ann Landers at 12 years of age, but I was. And she said that one of the most well-intended and yet least helpful phrases to use is, I know how you feel. And for some reason, at age 12, that stuck with me my whole life. So when I'm in line at a funeral or when I'm talking with someone who's going through a challenge and I will hear some other well-meaning person say to that person, oh, I know how you feel. My dad died when he was young too, or my brother was in an accident, or whatever. I cringe a little bit. And I think you don't know how they feel. Everybody's in a different place. Everybody has a different relationship with different people. So resist that phrase, I know how you feel. And by resisting it mentally, it causes you to step back and say, how do they feel? I wonder how they do feel. This is what habit 5 is all about. It's taking the time to really understand, not agreeing or disagreeing, but to really understand the other person's perspective. Emotions are high right now. Emotions of stress, of anger, of frustration, of worry, of concern. The intent of habit 5 is to truly understand the other person. The skill is simply to reflect back to them what you hear them feeling or saying. But again, don't hear the word skill and think, okay, well, this is some kind of contrived, you know, formula that I'm going to read or practice. If your intent is to really understand your child, your partner, your colleague at work, then do just that. And how you do that is say, gosh, you sound really concerned right now. Tell me a little bit more about that. And that's it. You know, we have a tendency to want to jump in and fix things. And I've learned, become the experts on, you know, we should all go work for the CDC ourselves. I'm listening to some of my family members who seem to know more than the next person on what quarantine really is and what you should be doing and telling everybody how they should do things right. And that's natural. And I think they're well-intended. But I think if we would slow down a little bit and take the time to really understand where the other person's coming from. Dr. Covey used to say, with people, fast is slow and slow is fast. And what he meant by that is when it comes to people and their emotions, you think you're being helpful by giving them answers or giving them suggestions or giving them advice. And actually, you're being most helpful when things are emotional to slow down and then be more effective by just hearing them out, by just listening to them. Remember that phrase, with people, fast is slow and slow is fast. I think we all need to slow down just a little bit here with our response, with our reaction, with our advice, and really hear people out. The deepest need of the human heart is to feel understood. This is probably one of Dr. Covey's most impactful quotes to me. The deepest need of the human heart is to feel understood. You think about that for yourself right now. Isn't that true? What is it like when you have that special family member or that colleague at work or that person who really takes the time to understand you? Oh, there's nothing more valuable. Your assignment this week is to see who you could be that person for. For whom in your life can you be that person that slows down and takes the time to really understand where they're coming from, really hear them out? I promise you, it will yield great rewards in your relationship with that person and with all of the relationships around you. See you next time.
If you'd like more resources to apply these concepts, please visit us at franklincovey.com/7habitstools.